And with the Xbox showcase coming up and the next Gears being rumored to be there, I'm hoping for this game to stop all of my doubts. Meaning, I don't want to see something like this again, okay? I don't want to see anything this underwhelming. Basically, in a nutshell, Xbox, you cannot F this up again. So, spoiler alert, everyone. Xbox did not F this up. Not only did we get a better look at Fable and Perfect Dark, but Xbox kept going with that nostalgia and had us witness probably one of the greatest Gears of War trailers ever, especially after the most recent ones, which I did complain about a bit in my last video. I was talking about how I don't want to see this again. And Xbox must have got the memo, thankfully, because we were hit with an amazing trailer showing us that not only is Gears of War back, but Gears of War is going back with Marcus and Dom. The duo that we love so much are back in a prequel called E-Day. Now, if you're new to the Gears of War series or you just need a refresher, E-Day stands for Emergence Day, and this was the day that the Locusts started their assault on Sarah, and you can see at the end of the trailer that that's exactly what's happening. It's complete chaos out there, as the Locusts are just tearing things up on a full-scale attack on the world, basically, and we get to see how it started. And I want to talk about this trailer a bit because it had me in complete shock. I did not expect to see what I saw that day when this appeared. I had no clue this was going to happen, and I knew I wanted to see something amazing, but I didn't know it was going to be this amazing. Now, it starts off with us seeing a television screen here where you can see a broadcast message, and this clearly is a clue that we're going back in time a bit. Then, of course, we see Marcus fighting the Locust, which is another telling point that this is indeed from the past. And then we saw Marcus reaching for and using a retro lancer, which is another clue that we are indeed going back in time, because the retro lancer was the main assault weapon before the chainsaw lancer. And so seeing the retro lancer, seeing Marcus fighting a Locust, seeing that broadcast on the TV, the clues were there to tell us this is indeed a prequel. And as Marcus almost falls to his death, he's saved by none other than Dom. And I gotta admit, Dom looked a little bit different to me. This shot right here, I was like, who is this? Because I was wrapping my head around all the scenarios and the wish list I had for this series, and oftentimes I would think about the Pendulum Wars and seeing Marcus with Dom's brother, Carlos, and seeing that unfold. So for a split second, I was like, maybe this is what I'm hoping for. But then of course it hit me later. That can't be. If there's a Locust there, the Pendulum War has already happened, and thus we have Dom. And it just kind of hit me like, wow. Just knowing that we're gonna get Marcus and Dom together again is awesome in itself. We're going to finally see how they developed their chemistry together and their brotherhood and why they're so close. And possibly maybe we might even see Maria make an appearance too, which could definitely tug at our heartstrings as well. It's gonna be awesome to see for sure. And I'm not alone on this. A lot of people were reacting to this trailer with tears, even actually getting emotional, especially when the Mad World instrumental hit. And that was a fine little detail they added in there, and that was just awesome to hear. And all the while, Unreal Engine showing off its capabilities with these graphics, and it just looked really, really good. And I'm sure I wasn't alone thinking that, yeah, Coalition is definitely going to show out with these graphics. But to actually knock it out of the park with the theme and premise for this game, that was not guaranteed. And they actually freaking did it. They did it. So all in all put together, this trailer was really well done. It knocked it out of the park. It gave us a glimpse at how dark and gritty we could see this game being, and just the franchise itself going back to that grittiness and that darkness. And I just cannot wait to see that again. And that was really what I most wanted. I wanted it to be dark and scary again and have horror-like elements. And this trailer that we just witnessed is pretty much confirming that we can anticipate that coming back for us. And that's something to be very excited about. So, what comes next? Well, there's already some rumors floating around that Gears of War is on track to release next year, which I don't think is that far-fetched. I could have some faith that they could do that, But what kind of leads me to believe we need to take it with a grain of salt is that Fable and some other games are actually aiming for that year as well. And I just don't know if Xbox would release all of them the same year, but you never know. And like I said, I don't think it's too far-fetched. I could imagine them showing gameplay at next year's showcase, having a multiplayer beta sometime in the summer, and then releasing the full game in the fall. It's something they've done before, and I just feel like it's possible. But ultimately, we want this thing to cook. We want it to be in the oven as long as possible to get it right. And if they need more time, they need to delay this game, do it. Do what you have to do to get this game perfect. That's my opinion on that. It is nice to know that Gears of War is back for the fans. It gets people excited about Xbox again. Like I was saying in my previous video, I think Xbox needs this, along with other titles to come out. Gears of War was a title that many of us bought an Xbox for. So to bring it back in this fashion, in this glorious fashion, is just such a great move by Xbox. I feel like they understood the assignment. They understood that Gears needed this, and it's just good to see. So I'm very excited about Gears of War and its future, and I'm sure I'm not alone on this. So we'd like to hear from you. How are you feeling about this new Gears of War announcement? How did you like the trailer? Let us know your thoughts in the comments section. Thank you so much for watching this video, and we will catch you in the next one.